had chairman of this global organization for Indian Army people, Sri Chaudhary Garu, Sri Jayachandra, chairman of the temple committee, Sri Durga Prasad, who has visited me, and then Sri Satyamurthy and Kumar, who initially requested me that I should interact with Indian community and also Telugu people, and then Madam Indian High Commissioner Vijaya Thakur, brothers and sisters of Indian origin belong to different Indian provinces, regions, religions, languages. I'm extremely happy to be at this to you today, this morning, that too in an auspicious place like Srinivas Perumal Koil temple, and in a beautiful atmosphere and a beautiful convention hall built up by these authorities. I'm really happy. My namaskaram to all of you, and also vanakkam. मैं सचमुच में बहुत आनंद महसूस कर रहा हूँ. कारण क्या है, मैं मेरा भारतीय बहनों और भाइयों से मिल रहा हूँ सिंगापुर आने के बाद. आई एम फीलिंग एट होम. मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम आई एम आउट ऑफ होम एंड आई हैव बीन डूइंग इट फॉर लास्ट 27 टू 30 इयर्स. माय डॉटर जोकिदा दिस इज our father comes to our house also once in a way. House also. So she says in Telugu, Manana appropriate my auntie could also start in Japan. I'm going around has been my passion to understand people, their problems, and also improve my knowledge in every sphere of public activity so that we can plan, you can think, you can plan, and you can execute in a better manner. I have been doing it right from the beginning of my political career since 1977. As a politician, before that as a student activist in Andhra University. Friends, today India is again on the race. Sometime back, people were thinking what is happening to India. The investments were not forthcoming. The mood was not upbeat. There was a fiscal deficit. There was a revenue deficit. There was a trade deficit. There was a current account deficit. Above all, there was a trust deficit. There was a policy paralysis, that what people, media commentators used to describe. I don't want to be political. Now the situation has totally changed. In the recent elections in India, after a gap of 30 years, people have overwhelmingly voted for a leader, for a party, and they have voted, according to me, for their better future. People, as if, India is of different languages, different religions, and different castes, different subcastes, all. As if they woke up early in the morning from Arunachal Pradesh to Andaman and talked to each other through video conferencing. They went to polling booths and then pressed the button and then one symbol and gave a majority to Sri Narendra Modi, then government of Bharatiya Janata Party. After a gap of 30 years, there is a stable government. There is a stable government and an able leader. People of India, people of India feel that Narendra Modi, Modi means 3D. Decisive, dynamic, and development oriented. 3-in-1, that is Narendra Modi, that's the situation. He is seen as if he has come to take care of the betterment of the future of our Indian youth and people. India has got a great tradition, culture, heritage from times immemorial. Our civilization, what we call Hindu civilization or Bharatiya civilization, is the oldest and ancient civilization in the world. When the world people do not know how to wear clothes, we were wearing good clothes and then leaving them and sending them matchboxes and exporting them. We have good traditions in every walk of life. We have good food which stood the test of all the seasons across the globe. Wherever you go, you find Indian restaurant, Indian recipe, and also a lot of foreigners also of those countries flocking to Indian restaurants because time-tested food. And we have the cultural heritage which our forefathers have lived and given to us. Adi kaal se, Veda kaal se, Punya kaal se, Purana kaal se. Jo logo ne jiya aur humko diya virasat mein mila, usko dekh ke log bahut prasanna hota hai pura duniya mein, even in India also. That's the greatness of this land. We have the traditions of respecting women. Now we are talking of a reservation, equality for women and all. If you go to Puranas, or Puranas say that those days, the education minister was Saraswati. The defense minister was Parvati. And the finance minister was Lakshmi. Now we are thinking whether we can give the power to them or not, what will happen at all. Because in between invasion of foreigners, we lost our moorings. Women, they prove excellent. If they are given an opportunity, they excel also, men. There is an inherent strength. Even in our rivers in India, majority of the rivers are named after women. Ganga, Kaveri, Krishna, Godavari, Narmada, Tapati, Sabarmati. All these rivers, Mahendra Tanaya, see the beautiful names. They are all original, you know. Even our country, we call it as Bharata Mata, not Bharata Pita. Mata, mother. That's the greatness of our culture. In India, people, the rickshaw puller also feels first he should get his sister married before he gets married. Respecting elders. Respecting guru, teachers, respecting the nature, respecting even the cattle, animal, we do puja. Pasulanu, pakshulanu pujinchadamu, cheemaku chakra petti, paavuku paalu posi, chuttuku dannam petti, alanti samskruti bharatadeshamlo undi. We have the Nagula Chavati, where we go and then feed the snake with milk, goddess snake. Snake bites, but still people go and feed the snake. That's the great tradition in India, which our forefathers has given to us. So we should feel proud of our origin. That's why I'm happy that it's a global organization, Indian origin. When you are in Singapore, you must be a Singaporean. You must follow the laws, you must follow the rules. But at the same time, you should never forget your roots. Never forget your motherland. Never forget your mother. I always say, Kanna Thalli, that means mother, Janma Bhumi, the birthplace, then Matru Bhasha, the mother tongue which has come from mother's womb, and then Matru Desam, the country which you are born, you should never forget them. Kanna Thalli, Kanna Thalli ni, Janma Bhumi ni, Matru Bhasha no, Matru Desani, Machipoyina vadu, Manavude kaadu ani cheppanu. You must remember your birthplace. You must remember your mother, you must remember your mother tongue, and you must remember your motherland, wherever you may be. That should be the attitude of the people. When I go to universities, I tell the students in Indian universities, people want to go abroad, nothing wrong, go. I tell them, go, land, get, and return to India. At the end of the day, at the end of the day, you have to spend your time with your people, with the near and dear. Your grandmother, your grandfather, your uncle, your aunties, your sisters, your sister-in-laws, brother-in-law, daughter-in-law, how many laws, we don't know. But the relationship, now you feel happy when you are there and you share your prosperity. your wealth with your neighbors. I'm not saying that everybody should go back to India. Before that, he earned sufficient land from others, not by education alone, by others. Even I had a learning class yesterday. I went to urban planning, then I went to the water management center here, then I had interacted with the people who are looking after the transport system of Singapore. All this you have to learn. A politician should be a learner. Always learn, learn, learn more. Not learn, 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 but learn, learn more. That should be. When you learn, if you have Saraswati, Lakshmi will come to you automatically. If you have Lakshmi, there is no guarantee Saraswati will come to you. So Saraswati is more important, knowledge is more important, education is more important. Education does not mean reading books. Reading people's life, going around the globe, understanding the problems, and then try to apply it to Indian context. And then passing on our knowledge of India to other countries, because we have a treasure of knowledge, treasure of knowledge. Our ordinary tatty tapper, weaver, fisherman, goldsmith, blacksmith, the cook, how much talent they have, inherent talent. Our food of idli, sambar, vada, dosa is now international. I don't think even the so-called American pizza and burger, only few shops here and there. Whereas our items are very popular because they are time tested. Then our saris, Kanchi saris, Kanchivaram saris, Venkatagiri saris, even Pochampalli saris. Saris are famous. Kota saris now of Rajasthan. They are famous worldwide, wherever it is. And the skill of our Indian people is amazing. That has to be a little upgraded. And then that's why the Prime Minister came with a 3S scheme. 3S. He said skill, scale, speed. This is a 3S mantra he has given to all of us. Skill, scale, and speed. Because India is a huge country. We have regional disparities. We have economic disparities. We have illiteracy level of 26 to 30%. We have poverty level of 25%. So we have to address those concerns. The Prime Minister of India is very much concerned about these inequalities. That's why he gave the mantra of skill, scale, and speed. Skill, upgrade the skills. Where first time he has set up a skill ministry in India. Skill upgradation, there is one ministry is created for that purpose. Upgrading the skills. Secondly, scale. If you go slowly, you can't achieve. You need to scale it up because of India's size. And then the speed, you have to go speed. Recently, he launched a financial inclusion scheme called as Jana Dhana Yojana, Pradhan Mantri Jana Dhana Yojana. 58% of Indian population do not have a bank account even today, after 68 years of independence. So, Prime Minister said, we must complete this. We all told him, yes sir, we'll do it within our time of 5 years. He said, no, 5 years, within 1 year. Some of us skeptical. Jo kaam 50 saal mein nahi ho paya. Wo 5 saal mein kaisa pura hoga? How can you complete in 5 years? Then he said, no, how can you complete in 1 year? He said, no, it should be done. You'll be surprised to know after 6 weeks, now I think six and a half weeks after launching this scheme, as on today, the latest figure shows that 6 crore 2 lakh people have enrolled them as a new bank holders in the country. He said this financial untouchability is not acceptable. Use such a strong expression. Financial untouchability of excluding 58% of Indian population from the banking services is no good. That's why the Jana Dhana Yojana is moving faster. Speed, scale, that is the purpose of his mission. He has taken many initiatives like Make in India. He invited the people from across the globe, come to India, make in India. Make in India, sell anywhere you like, we have no problem. But make them in India, so that people get employment. There is revenue generation, there is work. So he has given a lot of other catchy slogans. I compiled them and made it as a Missy DC. Missy means MI, is Make in India. Then SI means Skill India. Then DI means Digital India. Then CI means Green India. All these together, Missy DC. There is a, now The Prime Minister has a habit of connecting with the people directly. On August 15th, he spoke extempore without reference to a paper and spoke on ordinary issues. Ordinary issues. He did not speak on global issues. He did not address the global audience. There were a lot of ambassadors who were sitting there. The international media was focusing how Modi is going to speak first speech. He spoke about sanitation. He spoke about the need for toilets for the girls, child in the schools in the villages. He spoke about time sense. He spoke about saving energy. He spoke about cleanliness, sanitation. He started a Swachh Bharat mission, which I am monitoring it as Armed Our Minister. Swachh Bharat. Swachh means clean. Without Swachh, you cannot have Swasth Bharat. You cannot have a healthy India. So now the campaign is on. On October 2nd, Gandhi Jayanti day, he himself came out and then took a broom and the broom and then started cleaning. He went to a police station. People wanted to take him to a place. And then I think they would have cleaned it. Prime Minister in between diverted the route and went to a police station and started cleaning the police station. The message is that, and he gave a call, now all Amitabh Bachchan to Kamal Hassan to Rajinikanth to Nagarjuna to Chiranjeevi to everybody, not only cinema people but also business people, industry, Ambani's, Singhania's, everybody is joining because we want icons also to own this scheme. Mahatma Gandhi said, cleanliness is next to godliness. So that is the importance in India. Yesterday I was talking to Prime Minister, former Prime Minister, Emeritus Minister, I was inquiring, I put a lot of questions to him, like a student asking a teacher to get good answers about various aspects in Singapore. Then I asked him about this keeping the city clean. He said, we have fines. We are a fine city. So I told him, because of fines, you are a fine city. In India, straight away you can't go for fines. You have to first create awareness among the people, then you have to create the infrastructure of creating toilets and then sanitary facilities, solid waste management, sewerage treatment plants. And then, as a last resort, we have to think about some sort of this thing, because people also need incentives and disincentives also. This is another program of the Honorable Prime Minister. Friends, we have tried our best to remove the bottlenecks with regard to investment. A lot of investors are now looking to India. Today morning, I had a meeting with some of the CEOs based in Singapore. They are all eager to invest in India. We discussed about various aspects. And whatever obstacles are there, Prime Minister is trying to remove them one after another. We are trying to make business easy. Business easy. Business means, some people are saying, you are all interested in business only. Without business, there is no business, sir. One has to understand. Unless you have business, industry, manufacture, you cannot have jobs. And you have to create wealth, then only you can distribute. Some people in India, from the beginning, they always say, no, socialism, we must distribute. You can distribute, provided if you earn. Without earning, if you start distributing, then you will end in debt trap. That is what happened. Recently, Mr. Chidambaram on February 24th, the outgoing finance minister told Indian Parliament that 43.3% of our Indian revenue is going for debt repayment, interest repayment, 43.3%. So we have to come out of this situation. We have to learn. The Telugu also, from my childhood, I used to hear some of the leaders, some of the leftist oriented people used to say, Panchandi, Panchandi, Panchali. Panchali is distribute. పంచాలి అంటే ముందు పెంచాలి, పెంచకుండా పంచితే పంచ మాత్రమే మిగులుతుంది. యూ నీడ్ టు, ఇఫ్ యు గో ఆన్ డిస్ట్రిబ్యూటింగ్ వితౌట్ క్రియేటింగ్ దెన్ ఓన్లీ యువర్ యూ లెఫ్ట్ విత్ యువర్ పంచ అండ్ యూ నీడ్ నథింగ్ ఎల్స్. దట్స్ ద మీనింగ్ ఇన్ తెలుగు, తెలుగు సేయింగ్. సో ప్రైమ్ మినిస్టర్ ఈస్ నౌ కీన్ ఆన్ ఇంక్రీజింగ్ నౌ ద ఎకానమీ ఇస్ బ్యాక్ ఆన్ రైల్స్. నౌ ది growth rate is now 5.6. From 4.6, it was 5.6 now. During Atal Bihari Vajpayee's days, it was 8.4. And great people brought down to 4.6. And then now we are trying to take it up. Next year, we are hoping to reach 6.5. If the GDP grows more, the interest rates will come down. If the interest rates come down, then investments will increase. And jobs also will be increased. And there will be a proper climate. This is what the Honorable Prime Minister is trying to do. And he started, he made a humble beginning of inviting all the SAARC leaders for the swearing-in ceremony. Even during Jawaharlal Nehru time, this many number of heads of countries have not taken part in swearing-in ceremony. But first time, he brought everybody from Pakistan to Bangladesh to Nepal to Bhutan to Sri Lanka. All these countries have come to swearing-in ceremony. A good beginning has been made. First, to mobilize the neighborhood. Then he went to Bhutan, he went to Nepal, then he went to Brazil, then he went to Japan, then he has gone to America. You might have seen the scene in America. The Madison Square meeting is amazing. 20,000 people came on their own and they are waiting outside. Because in Western countries, people do not have time for these rallies, meetings and all. I remember as a young activist, I went to America in 1990, first time. Young Political Leaders Exchange Program. American Young Political Leaders Exchange Program. So after the tour, they told me that they will be taking us to a rally. I was excited because from the beginning, we were all involved in rallies. Then at the evening, it was in Little Rock, Arkansas State. So we went to the rally. And there were 700-800 people. Then the organizer, the guide told us, sir, request to rally in the recent. I said, even a municipal ward councillor in my village, now the same number of people. Then he told me, sir, America, people are not free, they won't come here. At best, they will be seeing the television. They will not come to rallies like India, where lakhs of people come to rallies and all. Lakhs of people. Recently, I've seen Narendra Modi's rallies. Lakhs of people are there everywhere. But they said, but there, in America, 20,000 people in the Madison Square. My daughter just now is in Australia. She went to admit her son for some cricket coaching. She was telling me, Nana, PM is coming here somewhere around 18th or 19th. Already the, all tickets are booked. You know this thing, a lot of people are asking space, space, space. Because space is a big issue there. So that's sort of interest in India. It's not interest in Modi alone. It's an interest in India. That's why it said India is raising again. And we must, all people of Indian origin, we must contribute. In our whatever manner we can, through your knowledge, through the information, or through investments. I am sure if we all work together, India will become a super economic power and will regain its lost glory. Earlier it was known as a Viswa Guru. Once upon a time to the entire world, India was known as a Viswa Guru. Pyongyang, Pahiyan. Lot of foreigners, Chinese historians, commentators, they came and wrote about India, about Takshashila, about Nalanda, the universities. Lot of people in those days, they used to come and read in India. That was the situation. Because of our culture and our ancient knowledge and all, we must take back the country again to those heights. And I am confident. For that, people of India, they should be motivated, they should be guided. Yadha Raja Tadha Praja, if the leader is good, everything will be good. If the overhead tank is polluted, even if you change the tap and make a gold tap also, you won't get fresh water. The overhead tank has to be clean. Today, the Prime Minister is clean, honest, his team is clean and honest, and he is sure, he told people, he told government employees also, you work 11 hours, I will work 12 hours. You work 12 hours, I will work 13 hours, he said. And he told, I won't eat, I don't eat, allow others to eat. Not food, but other things. He said it in plain words. Nenu tinanu, evadini tinalevanu. Nenu nidrapovanu, nenu parigettanu, mimmalni parigettistanu ani cheppadu. So this is what is required in India is speed and commitment. And as I told you, our culture, we must feel proud of our culture and our heritage. This is a point I want to impress upon you. మనందరం కూడా ఆది కాలం నుంచి వేదకాలం నుంచి పురాణ కాలం నుంచి పుణ్యకాలం నుంచి మన పూర్వీకులు అనుభవించి రంగరించి మేళవించి మనకు అందించిన వారసత్వం అయితే ఉందో ఆ వారసత్వాన్ని చూసి మనం మన కట్టు మన పొట్టు మన మాట మన పాట మన సాంప్రదాయం మన ఆట వీళ్ళు ఎప్పుడూ మర్చిపోకూడదు మనం అందరం సీ ద ఇండియన్ ట్రెడిషన్స్ అండ్ కల్చర్ వీ షుడ్ ప్రిజర్వ్ ఇట్ అట్ హోమ్ వీ షుడ్ స్పీక్ ఇన్ అవర్ మదర్ టంగ్ అట్ హోమ్ Speak in English, speak in Hindi, speak in Malay, speak in Chinese, speak in whatever language and you go outside. But at home, speak to your children and your family members in your mother tongue. Be it Telugu, Tamil, Malayala, Kannada, Marathi, Punjabi, Assami, whatever language it is, the mother language, you should never, never, never forget it. It's because so beautiful and so sweet. And secondly, about the culture also, you must feel proud of your cultural heritage. When some people talk of Hindu, then they say, sir, Hindu is religion. Hindu is not religion. Hindu is a way of life. It's a culture. Hindu is a way of life. It's not culture. And it's not a narrow-minded religious concept. The name of India is Hindustan. The name is not given by Narendra Modi or Atal Bihari Vajpayee or Venkaiah Naidu. It was given by our forefathers, Hindustan. Hindustan. And if the Hindu is narrow or religious, then why is the Hindu newspaper? The newspaper name is Hindu. Does it mean to say that it's only for Hindus? There is the Hindustan Times. There is Hindustan newspaper, Hindustan Shipyard, Hindustan Aeronautics Limited, Hindustan Machine Tools, HMT Watch. Even on August 15th, people say all officers, governor, Rashtrapati, Chief Minister, Prime Minister, everybody say Jai Hind. Does it mean to say Hindu ko Jai, Bagin ko Nai, aisa hai kya? Hindustan ko Jai Ho. Hindustan ko Jai Ho, Hindustan. That is the slogan. So we should never feel shy to talk about our origin, talk about our culture. Matam kaadu, matam vyaktigatamainadi. Ee matam nu Muslim aina, Christian aina, Christian aina, nu devalayaniki vellu, church ki vellu, masjid ki vellu, gurudwara ki vellu, nee ishtam vachina pooja vidhanam avalambinchu. But at the same time, Bharat desanni preminchu, Bharatiya samskrutini gaurivinchu anedi mukhya gurtu pettuko. Nee gaddam pettuko, nee gaddam naake maata. పొట్టు పెట్టుకోవాలంటే ఎలాంటి పొట్టు అయినా పెట్టుకో, మంచి పొట్టు పెట్టుకో, నిలువు పొట్టు పెట్టుకో, అడనామం పెట్టుకో, నిరుణామం పెట్టుకో, కానీ దేశానికి మాత్రం పంగనామం పెట్టదు మాత్రం. సో దిస్ ఇస్ వాట్ ఈస్ రిక్వైర్డ్ టుడే ఫ్రెండ్స్. యువర్ ఆల్ ఇన్ సింగపూర్, యువర్ హ్యాంగ్ కంఫర్ట్ గుడ్, యు హ్యావ్ ఎ గుడ్ అడ్మినిస్ట్రేషన్ అండ్ స్టేబుల్ గవర్నమెంట్ హియర్. బికాస్ ఆఫ్ ద స్టెబిలిటీ ఆఫ్ ద గవర్నమెంట్ దీస్ రిఫార్మ్స్ కుడ్ టేక్ ప్లేస్. This is what is acknowledged by the Chief Minister, Prime Minister. The first Prime Minister, the reforms he brought in the country are really amazing. And because of his hard work and foresight and vision, Singapore could reach this stage. That leader needs vision. Secondly, he need to go for a mission, not for commission. And then India is on the move. India is on the right path now. India will definitely rise. This is my confidence. So I convey my greetings to all of you, to all the Indians living in Singapore. Wish you all the best. God bless you all. We are all the sannidhi of Lord Venkateswara, who will definitely bless us with a good intention. If you work hard, God's blessings will always be there. And any one of you interested to come and invest in India, you are welcome. Invest, promote investment through your friends. They are also welcome. If there are any problems, you can get in touch with our High Commissioner. Because you come to India, you can call on me, you can meet other ministers also in India. And then shortly, our Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh, Chandrababu Naidu, is coming here. He is also another progressive person, a visionary. He has developed Hyderabad earlier. Now he is keen to develop a new capital for Andhra Pradesh. Recently, unfortunately, there was a Hudhud cyclone in Vishakhapatnam, but people are strong enough to withstand that, and I am confident Vishakhapatnam will become an international destination as far as the port activity is concerned. American government have agreed to cooperate to making Visakhapatnam as an international level smart city. And my ministry is working on creating 100 smart cities, then 10 heritage cities, then 500 cities. We want to have urban renewal and then rejuvenation in the urban areas. These are all programs that are going on. As I told you, housing for all in the coming days. That's also another scheme. I think I have taken much of your time, ma'am. When I saw all of you, I got inspired seeing our Indian people here at home. I'm thankful to the organizers, Dr. Nair and other people who have taken pains, the Telugu Samajam and the Samajam of different Indian origins, we have all joined together. When you are outside, you need total unity. Irrespective of caste, creed, sex, religion and region, we are Indians. That has to be alag bhasha, alag vesh, phir bhi apna ek desh. Vividhata mein ekata, Bharat ka visheshata. Vesham bhasha vereina, manamanta bharatiyam. That should be the back of our mind. I hope that you will continue the same traditions. Namaskar, Nandri, Vanakkam.